for those who don't know, just state who you are and what you do and what you've been doing.
My name is Larry Poncho Brown, and I've been a professional artist for 37 years.
Could you explain the creative process as a whole?
I try to tell most artists that the creative process is not complicated. The first thing about the creative process is that recognizing that this energy, this creative energy, is something that was given to us for whatever reason. I don't want to make this a spiritual conversation, but you're giving it for a reason. I believe that right-brained people or creative people have this ability because we need another voice, we need to be able to process, we have a different way of thinking and expressing ourselves. So, with that being said, creativity to me is a form of therapy. And that's what all of us get from the whatever, whether you're a writer, musician, artist, whatever, that's what that main energy is. Most of us really don't care if we sell our stuff or whether people recognize our stuff because we're already in another zone when we're creating work anyway. So I start with that first, the therapeutic side of why we're given this and the difference between right brain and left brain thinkers. Right brain thinkers definitely feel the world different and they express the world different. And so I don't blow it up as being better than or less than. And you won't hear me talking a lot about talent. You'll hear me talking about the true essence of where creativity starts. And then after that, depending on whether you model yourself or want to do it as a career, that's another whole chapter, that's another conversation. The creative process is not the same for every person. That's the first thing. I think anybody that is serious about being an artist, they have to really take the time to track what their creative cycle is. It's really a cycle. Like for us, I don't paint every day, all day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. I just don't do that. I know some artists that are on that kind of creative track. I get frustrated because I'm not on that creative track. But I think you gotta sit down and figure out what yours is. The biggest problem I find with today's generation is that they're doing more thinking and less work. See, the old school days, we were doing the work. We had time to think because there weren't a lot of options and opportunities out there. So you were doing it because you loved doing it, you felt like doing it, you were compelled to do it. Whereas now everything's so commercialized, people are automatically trying to figure out how they're gonna survive from it, whether they're gonna make money from it, whatever, whatever. So it's a tough spot. All artists gotta go through that. You gotta go through that process. But if you ain't working, you bullshit. And if you're just thinking, you're doing nothing. Thinking is nothing until you bring it to fruition. And most people now don't wanna take their craft. Most people today think they have more talent than they actually have. And I'm clear now, the portfolio reviews at colleges, I talk to high school kids, middle school kids, I see it. Most of them are not doing the right amount of work to grow. And at some point, that's what you're shooting for, is to get yourself on some sort of momentum. Doesn't matter whether it's a fast momentum or slow momentum, but when you're thinking, you're basically sitting still. Turn this shit up, nigga. Turn this shit up. Tell me who the bitch, nigga, hating on me. Jumping on